हाई स्टूडेंट्स वेलकम टू गौरी स्मार्ट चैनल मैं डे थ्री की वस्तु डे थ्री भाग में सैट्स कांसेप्ट मैं नेजु सो सैट्स कांसेप्ट चाला बहुत चला चला अच्छे इध इंग्लिश मीडियम को इंग्लिश मीडियम मत सो ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड और अर्थम करते उसे असल अर्थम कंग्लीश अर्थम चुस्कानी ट्रई चयी सो सैट्स में खचिता ट्रिपल ईटी की खचिता मन की त्री मार्क्स ग्यारंटी अंडी मिनिमम त्री मार्क्स वस्ताई इंक आलस्य सो वीडियो ने स्टार्ट सो वीडियो वस्ते मेक और लाइक मेक चाहिए अदे विधि फ्रेंड्स अंदर की शेयर चाहिए इंक आलस्य वीडियो स्टार्ट सैट सो वट मीन बै सैट सैट अंटे मन की द कलेक्शन आफ् वेल डिफाइंड आबजेक्ट इज कॉल्ड सैट The collection of well-defined objects is called set. So, well-defined means it should be exist in our universe. For example, the number of boys in the class. Number of boys means how many boys? That is not well-defined. So, we have to specify the 5 students in 10th B class, 6 students in 10th A class. That is the well-defined. So, the number of natural numbers is not a well-defined. Number of natural numbers, how many natural numbers? So the natural numbers below 5 are well defined because we are saying below 5 means 1 2 3 4 we are saying well defined so the collection of well defined objects is called set the collection of well defined objects is called set and sets are denoted by capital letters the elements in the sets are denoted by small letters sets are denoted by capital letters and the elements are denoted by small letters so here I am writing a e I o u this is a well defined so those are the vowels in English So the vowels in the English I am denoting with A. So the sets are denoted by capital letters and the elements in the sets are denoted by small letters. So in this set, these sets can be written as two forms. One is roster form and set builder form. So roster form is also called as tabular form or list form. Roster form is also called as tabular form or list form. Means what? The elements in the set are written by using commas and those are kept in flower brackets or special brackets see here these are the flower brackets in this flower brackets I am writing some numbers those are 1 3 5 7 9 so these are the odd numbers so I am denoting with o so the numbers which are written in the set and those are separated by comma and those are within the flower brackets those are called set builder form or tabular form or rule form now this same thing only if I write formula the same thing only if I write in formula then that is called set builder form or rule form means some rule will be there so the set builder form is nothing but converting the roster form into a formula or a structure as some rule then that is called set builder form so the same thing I will write now here o is equal to x such that x is on odd number so which is less than 11 which is less than 11 see here this is I am writing x such that x is an odd number so which is less than 11 which is less than 11 means up to 9 only this also can be written as x such that x is an oval in English oval in English so in English ovals are 5 those are a e I o so like that we can write sets and most very important thing in the set the elements are identical the elements are identical means so if you write one more I we should treat only one because one more I also same I only means how many elements are repeating we should not consider only we should consider the identity elements means a comma e comma I means a e I o u only so the elements are identical now we are going to discuss about types of sets so types of sets first one is empty set this is also called as void set or null set void set or null set what is empty set a set in which no element is there a set in which no element is there then that set is called void set or null set or empty set it is denoted by pi so general example they will ask in exam what is a general example means null set a set in which no element is there, then the set is called empty set. Now see here, pi is an empty set. Flower brackets, no elements, that is also empty set. So these two are equal. These two are equal. Now I will give the example. The natural numbers less than 1 is an empty set. The natural numbers less than 1 is an empty set. And x belongs to n, x square is equal to 9. So x belongs to n, x square is equal to 9. It is also empty set, because if I take minus 3, minus 3 square is equal to 9. So that is not there. So it is also empty set. We should not take 3, 3 square is equal to 9. So because it is satisfying again minus 3, if you substitute minus 3, minus 3 square is equal to 9. So that is also not a set. So this is an empty set. Next. Singleton set. Singleton set. A set which is having only one element, then that set is called singleton set. The set which is having only one element. A set which is having only one element, that set is called singleton set. So example I will say here. Even prime number. Even prime number, how many are there? Singleton set. So even prime number is, so singleton set. So this is not empty set, this is a singleton set, because x belongs to n, x square is equal to n means, so 3 square is equal to 9, means only one solution, that is, so set is 3. So sorry, this is a singleton set. Empty set means less than natural numbers, means a number which is less than 1, a natural number which is less than 1, that is called empty set. And a man in moon is also empty set. And a boy in the girl's school, it is also empty set. So a boy will not be there in a girl's school. So a boy in girl's school is also an empty set. Next. Singleton set is one element should be there. Next. Finite set. A set which has countable elements. A set which has countable elements, then the set is called finite set. So example, vowels, consonants, and less than 11 odd numbers. So many we can say finite set. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Up to 10 numbers, that's also a finite set. So means we have to count. Then if you can count, then those are the finite set. Now, infinite set. A set which has uncountable elements. A set which has uncountable elements, then the set is called uncountable. So set means infinite set. Infinite set. Next. Equal sets, equivalence sets. These two are most very important. Equal sets. If let us suppose A and B are non-empty sets. A and B are non-empty set. And A is having A comma B comma C comma D. And B is having C comma A comma D comma B. These two are equal sets. These two are equal sets. See A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D. Two sets are said to be equal sets if they have same elements and number of elements. If they have equal number of elements and same elements then the two sets are equal sets. Now, equivalent sets. Two sets are said to be equivalent sets if they have same number of elements, but need not be same elements. If two sets are said to be equivalent sets if they have same number of elements. Number of elements are equal. See here, A is equal to A, B, C, D, and B is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. See here, 4 elements are there, here also 4 elements. So if A comma B are having same number of elements, then the A and B are equivalent sets. So every equal sets are equivalent sets, but every equivalence need not be equal sets. That point you remember. So here A equal to B means these are the equal sets. A is equivalence means like this, you have to write 1 to 1 function like that. Means A 2 and B 1, C 4, D 3 like that, or A 4, C 3, D B 2, D 1 like that. So 1 to 1 relation should be there. Means how many number of elements are there, that many number of elements. So the elements should not be equal, may be equal or may not be equal. But so number of elements are equal, then those are equivalent sets. Number of elements are equal and elements are also same, then those are called equal sets. Next. Cardinal number of a set. A set which is having some elements, then how many elements are there in that set, that is called cardinal set of a cardinal number of a set. For example, the cardinal number of this set is n of a. Number of a is nothing but 5. Cardinal number of this set is
5. The cardinal number of this set is n of O, that is equal to 5, because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Next, the cardinal number of this set is n of B is equal to 1. The cardinal set of this one, only 1. 1, 2, 3, 4. Number of A, n of A is equal to 4. The cardinal number of this set is 4. So, like that we can say. So, the number of elements present in a set, that is called cardinal number of a set. Next, universal set. For some condition, for some situations, so the subsets of all sets, the set which is having so many subsets, that set is called universal set. For example, our school is containing first class, second class, third class, fourth class, fifth class, sixth class, seventh class, eighth class, ninth class, tenth class. So, our school is universal set. In number system, if you take real number is a universal set, because real number is having natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, rational numbers, irrational numbers. So, for some conditions, for some situations, for some conditions, so a set is having so many subsets, then though that set is called universal set. Universal set is denoted by mu. Universal set is denoted by mu. This is a symbol mu. Universal set is denoted by mu. And universal sets are represented by rectangles. So, rectangles are used for universal sets. Next, we will go for subset. Subset. See here, subset means if we consider two sets A and B, if you consider two sets A and B, A and B, what are the elements present in A, those are also present in B. If what are the elements present in A, those are also present in B, then A is called subset of B. Then A is called subset of B. A is a subset of B. Example, I will say A is equal to 1, 3, 5. B is equal to 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11. See here, 1, 3, 5 I have taken A, those are also present in B, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11. So, that's what A is subset of B. A is a subset of B. So, example I will give you, you can easily understand. A is equal to 1, 2, 3. B is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, clearly A is subset of B. A is a subset of B. What are the elements present in A? Those are also present in B. So, A is a subset of B. Now, superset. This is also same thing, but we have to write reverse. Here also same definition. What are the elements present in A? Those are also present in B. But if you write B is superset of A, we have to write like this. Same definition, B is superset of A. Means if in the exam, if A is a subset of B, then which of the following is satisfying superset condition? If they are asking like that, you have to write the correct answer. So, you have to choose the correct answer, B subset of A. B is superset of A. Now, proper subset. Proper subset. See here, if A is subset of B and A not equal to B, then A is called proper subset of B. A is called proper subset of B. Subset means what? See here, subset I will say, A is subset of B. For example, A is equal to 1 comma 2 and B is equal to 1 comma 2 comma 3 comma 4 comma 5. Now, A subsets what? Only if I take this A is equal to 1 comma 2. So, first one is empty set. So, 1, 2, 1 comma 2. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. These 4 are subsets of A. These 4 are subsets of A. So, like that, this is also having 4 subset. In that, 1 comma 2 is another, that is A. That is also B. So, A is not equal to B. Means, what is the set we are taking that should not equal to itself. Then, we can say A is subset B and A not equal to B. Then, A is a proper subset of B. Proper subset of B. So, number of elements I will say in the last. So, shortcut formulas are there. In that, I will explain. Now, power set. Power set is denoted by P of A. A set which is having subsets of a set. A set which is having subsets of a set, then that set is called power set. Then the set is called power set. See here. A means 1 comma 2. P of A means
empty set, singleton set 1, singleton set 2 and 1 comma 2. So here 4 subsets are there. So in the 4 subsets, it is a power set. Now basic operations, there are 4 basic operations are there. So in these 4 operations we will discuss now, already we know very well. So first one is union, union of 2 sets. Union of 2 sets is nothing but it is a new set which is having all elements, by taking in set A and set B, we know very well. Union of A, 2 sets is a set in which by taking all elements in A and B together and writing in one set, that is called union, Now intersection. The intersection of 2 sets is a set which is having common elements of set A and set B. The intersection of 2 sets which is having common elements of A and B, that is called intersection of 2 sets. Next, difference. So now here see, I will give the example A union B, A intersection B, A minus B. So A is equal to 1, 2, 3. B is equal to 3, 4, 5. So A is equal to 1, 2, 3. B is equal to 3, 4, 5. A is equal to 1, 2, 3. Minus 3, 4, 5. Now see here, I will give the full examples. A union B means the union of 2 sets is a set which is having all elements of set A and B. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So all elements present, together we will take. Now intersection, means a set which is having common elements. Common elements means here 3 is there, here also 3 is there. So singleton 3 is the answer. Now A minus B. A minus B means the elements should present in A only, should not present in B. So here 1 is present in A and 1 is not present in B. So answer 1, comma. 2 is present in A and 2 is not present in B. So 2 is also there. 3 is present in A and also B. So we should not take 3. So 1 comma 2 is the answer. So like that, union, intersection and minus we can say. Now disjoint sets, most very important disjoint sets. If A comma B are, not having any common elements, then A comma B are disjoint sets. That means A intersection B is equal to pi. So in the recent policy exam it has given, if A comma B are disjoint set, then which of the following is correct, they are giving. So A intersection B is equal to pi. And also if A is equal to pi and B is not equal to So if A is equal to pi, then A intersection B is also pi. And if B is equal to pi and A intersection B is also pi. See here, if A intersection B, in this A is pi means the common elements pi only. In A intersection B, if B is pi, then common elements pi only. So if A comma B are disjoint sets, then A intersection pi and A intersection B, if A is equal to pi, then A intersection B is also pi, and B intersection pi, then A intersection B also pi. Next, symmetric difference, most very important symmetric difference, that is I will say. Now listen, symmetric difference is nothing but A minus B, means the elements should present in A and should not present in B. Union B minus A, the elements in present in B and should not present in A. So that is called symmetric. So that is A delta B. So A delta B is nothing but symmetric difference to B. That is the formula. So A delta B is equal to A minus B union B minus A. Otherwise, you take all union, in that subtract A intersection. So union of A and B minus intersection of A and B. So that is also A delta B. Now complementary set. So what is complementary set? The elements should present in mu should not present in A. That is only complement. So that is denoted by A dash. The elements should present in mu and should not present in A. This is called complement. Complementary set. ఆఫ్ ఏ కాంప్లిమెంటరీ సెట్ ఆఫ్ ఏ ద ఎలిమెంట్స్ షుడ్ ప్రెజెంట్ ఇన్ మ్యూ అండ్ షుడ్ నాట్ ప్రెజెంట్ ఏ సో హియర్ వి ల్యాండ్ ద ఎలిమెంట్స్ షుడ్ ప్రెజెంట్ ఇన్ ఏ షుడ్ నాట్ ప్రెజెంట్ బి దట్ ఈస్ ఏ మైనస్ బి ద ఎలిమెంట్స్ షుడ్ ప్రెజెంట్ ఇన్ మ్యూ అండ్ షుడ్ నాట్ ప్రెజెంట్ ఇన్ ఏ సో దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ ఏ డాష్ ఏ కాంప్లిమెంట్ నెక్స్ట్ విల్ గో ఫర్ షార్ట్ కట్స్ సో టుడే షార్ట్ కట్స్ విల్ గో ఫర్ నెక్స్ట్ షార్ట్ కట్స్ shortcuts maximum and minimum elements of some union b or intersection b or minus b they will ask now we'll see here for example here I am taking 5 and here I am taking 2 so in the b set 5 elements is there and a set 2 elements is there in the b set 5 elements is there and the a set 2 elements is there now maximum elements of A union B. Maximum elements of A union B. See here in the A B set A B C D E and A set 1, 2. So total how many? So 5 plus 2, 7. So maximum element 7 means n of A plus n of B 2 plus 5 that is equal to 7. 2 plus 5 that is equal to 7. So they will ask in 8888 definitely these bits will be coming because some difficulties is there. Now minimum elements of A union B. Minimum elements of A union B. See here, B again I am taking A B C D E and A I am taking A B. Now if I find intersection, then what will I get? A B C D E means 5 elements only I will get. So n of B. So 5 n of B. So I am giving live examples also. Now maximum elements of A intersection B. Maximum elements of A intersection B. So again. Maximum elements of A intersection B. A, B, C, D, E. A, B. Now, if I find intersection, what will I get? A, B. So, A, B means N of B. So, N of A. Sorry, N of A. So, means I am getting A, comma B. That is N of A. Now, minimum elements of A intersection B. Now, if I take A, B, C, D, E and 1, comma 2. There is no intersection. There is no common elements. If there is no common elements, then that is an empty set. If it is an empty set, the number of elements is 0. The number of elements is 0. So that is a 0. Now, number of subsets in A. See here, A is 2 elements. So A is 2 elements, 2 square means 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. If A is having 3 elements, 2 cube means 8. If A is having 4 elements, 2 power 4, 16 elements. If A is having 5 elements, 2 power 5, that is 2 power 5 means 32 elements. That is the number of the subset formula 2 power n. Number of the proper subsets. For example, A is having 3 elements. So generally subsets how many? 2 cube, that is 8. Now they are asking proper subset. Proper subset means it should not be equal to that set itself. It should not be equal to itself. So means minus 1. So 8 minus 1 that is 7. That is 8 means 2 power n minus 1. 2 power n. So 2 power n minus 1. That is the answer. Number of non-empty proper subsets. Subsets is 8. Proper subset is 7. Non-empty means empty set also we have to remove. Empty set also we have to remove means 2 power n minus 2. 2 power n minus 2. Number of elements in a power set. Number of elements in a power set. So power set. So where we have written power set? Yeah. This is a power set. So 1, 2, 3, 4 means 2 power n. So A is having 2 elements, 1 comma 2, 2 square A is having 2 elements. So 1 comma 2. So 2 square means 4. So power set is also 2 power n. Power set is also having formula 2 power n. Now some laws of algebraic of sets is there, that is we will discuss now. Listen, commutative law. What is commutative law? We know very well. A plus B is equal to B plus A. So that is the STD we learned day before day. So day before day we learned A plus B is equal to B plus A, or A into B is equal to B into A. That is called commutative law. Here we will see here. A union B is equal to B union A. If you find A union B, some answer you will get. If you find B union A, same answer you will get. So that's what A union B is equal to B union A. So that is called commutative law under union. Same like that, A intersection B is equal to B intersection A. That is also commutative law. So they will ask, which of the following is commutative law in sets? So you have to select A and B is equal to B and A. Like that you have to select. Now, associative law. So SSA to law. A union B union C is equal to A union B union C. A union of B union C is equal to A union B of union C. Like that, A intersection B intersection C is equal to A intersection B of intersection C. A intersection of B intersection C is equal to A intersection B of intersection C. That is a associative law. Next law is identity law. In sets also identity law is there. Students, please don't neglect these formulas, because in the recent policy they have given associative law. A into B into C is equal to A into B into C. You have seen. Otherwise, once you check the paper, definitely you will find the associative law. Now, associative law completed. Now, identity law. What is identity law? A plus 0 is equal to A into 1 is equal to A. Here, if you take A, you should get answer A. By doing universe and by doing intersection, what will you get A? See, A union something is equal to A intersection something is equal to A. So you have to do. If I do union, if I take pi, A union pi. So if I find the union of these two, because pi means no elements, A means those only. Again, I will get A. So here, pi is the identity element in the set. Identity element in the set. If I find intersection, mu, if I take mu, A intersection mu is equal to A intersection mu is equal to A. So means if I find intersection, the mu means all elements will be there, A means some elements. If you find intersection, some elements will be there, those are nothing but A. So that is the concept. So identity law, associative law and completive law, some more laws are there, those I will give in an example. So in an exam, so you can find and you can write. Now Venn diagrams. Every set is denoted by ellipse. Every set is denoted by, in the diagram, so ellipse. And the universal set is a rectangle. Now see here, this is the rectangle. In this rectangle, this is A, this is B. This is a universal set. So like this we can denote. So A union B, if I want, means this is the union B. If I want intersection, this is called intersection. If I want A minus B, this is a A minus B. Means only this part. So the elements should present in A and should not present in B. So like this, so many shortcuts are there. Tomorrow, there are 15 important models, including 15 models. I will explain some more most very shortcut models. So in the sets, those are most very very important. Definitely tomorrow class is most very very important, because I will say without taking elements we can say the answers. A union B, A minus B dash, A intersection B dash, A minus B union B dash. Like this some problems will be there. Those are all problems I'll explain using shortcuts. Means A is means rows and B is means columns. Like this some important shortcut is there. Those most very important problems tomorrow I'll explain. So please don't neglect tomorrow, watch the video. And that's it friends. Today concept is lesson, and tomorrow sets important models, 15 models and some more shortcuts is there. So if you like this video, so you just like it. If you want to share, you just share it. And if anyone coming to this channel first time, please subscribe my channel and please press the all bell icon, then you will get my notifications whichever the video I uploaded. So definitely you will get the video. So thank you very much for watching my video. Thank you very much. Bye bye.